We're talking about knowledge of the future in movies, YouTube channel, Easter Egg Psychic. And in this clip, I'll cover an item from American Graffiti, 1973. There are many actors in this movie with small roles or are extras or had small cameo appearances. I do not know the name of this actress. She appears in a scene about 14 minutes into American Graffiti. So this is the scene where Paul LeMat, John Milner, he pulls out onto the strip and pulls up next to this car full of girls and engages in a conversation with the passenger. Now, in the shadows in the back seat of this car is actress Mackenzie Phillips, who later gets in the car with Paul LeMat. But I will point out the actress who engages in the dialogue, and I believe that this actress may resemble movie director Roger Corman, but I'm not exactly sure who else she may resemble. Astute Roger Corman fans out there, test your memory banks, and possibly you can find another actor, crew member, some personality involved with Roger Corman who may match up. Maybe the biggest direct tie-in that you can cite between American Graffiti and Roger Corman, Dementia 13, a movie from 1963, Coppola's feature film directorial debut. Producer of American Graffiti and Dementia 13, this was produced by Corman. The title of this movie is shown in American Graffiti. It's on the movie theater marquee. In the scene where Richard Dreyfuss and the Pharaoh's gang sabotage the police car of Holstein. Now, Paul LeMat, he was in the movie Caroline at Midnight in 1993, and this was produced by Corman. And later on, Mackenzie Phillips is in the car with Paul LeMat when they run into Harrison Ford, Bob Falfa in American Graffiti. Now, Harrison Ford was in a movie, A Time for Killing, in 1967. This was a Western directed by Roger Corman, as well as Phil Carlson. My YouTube channel is Easter Egg Psychic. There I go back, I look at movies and television from the past. I analyze these for possible references to future media. These may appear in the form of anecdotes, idioms, anagrams, hidden in the subtext of the work in question. I also use an unconventional method where I look at the likenesses of the actors. And what I found is you can take the likenesses, match these up to some of the anecdotal items, and show past, present, and future information about actors and other personalities, or may resemble the personalities in the movie or television episode that you're watching. Thanks for watching.